comment makes you sound like your mother.
No, Tasha will believe you because you're there. I mean, look at us. You look like a Vermeer and I look like an extra in Potemkin.
Jamie, I think someone's watching us.
Do I look all right?
You know what I resent?
What?
Oh, just about everything except you. I mean, I resent having to pay the phone bill, being nice to the super, finding meaningful work, find love, get hurt. God, all of it I resent deeply.
So, what's the alternative?
Dependency. I could marry that bird who's staring at us.
No,
that's not a solution. I guess I could always move back to Brookline, you know, get a master's in something useful like women's pottery, do a little freelance writing. Oh, God, it's so exhausting.
Oh, he's coming.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey, you're Harry Cornwall. I used to sit behind you during 20th Century Problems. I always thought you were a beautiful girl. Maurice Sterling.
Hi. And this is Janie Plumberg.
Sure, I remember you. I used to see you and Harriet together all the time at Cambridge. You know, I always thought you looked more attainable then. Frightened to death, but attainable. You know, I'm not attracted to cold people anymore. Who needs that kind of trouble?
I don't know.
So, what do you do?
Oh, I scream here on Central Park South. Take my breakdown.
Jamie and I just moved back to New York together. Well, at the same time. See, I lived in Italy for a year, and Jamie was lingering in Brookline, Massachusetts.
Oh, good old Brookline. Hey, you ever go to Jackie Marion's restaurant? Unbelievable Kasha Bartnishka.
Excuse me?
Kasha. Little noodle bow ties and barley. My father's in the restaurant business. Are you familiar with Ye Olde Sterling Taverns?
Sure, that's a national chain.
My father's chain.
Well,
I'm on call. I'm a doctor. You kidding?
Well.
Well, look, maybe you should sit for a minute. Reminisce about 20th Century Problems.
I wish I could. I gotta be going. Bye. Jamie Blumberg. Is your brother Ben Blumberg?
Yup, that's our brother Ben.
You know, I went to Camp Cupid's with Ben when I was 9.
Yup, that's my brother Ben.
Hey, if you see your brother, would you tell him Murray Schlimovitz says hello?
Who's Murray Schlimovitz?
Me.
Oh.
Before my father owned the Sterling Taverns, he used to own the Schlimovitz kosher dairy restaurants in Brooklyn. But about 15 years ago, all the Schlimovitz restaurants burned down. So for the sake of the family and the business, we changed our names before I hit Harvard. Well, it was nice seeing you. Bye.
Bye. What were you doing? Maybe you choose to sit and reminisce about 20th Century Problems?
Look, Marty Sterling can make a girl a nice husband.
Now you really sound like your mother.
Patty, do you know who that man's father is?
He's an arsonist.
No, he's a genius. Mr. Sterling, the little man who comes on TV in a colonial suit and a bowler hat. To let you know, he's giving away all the free popovers and shrimp you can eat at Ye Olde Salad and Relic Park. That guy is Milky Schlimovitz, Marty Sterling's father.
It's all right. I can make do without Dr. Murray Marty and his father's popovers. Oh, I have to get back to that interview. My friend Joe Stein, the head of, he says they'll hire you if you go back for a second interview.
Well, if you don't marry Marty Sterling, I'll marry him. Just wait till I tell my parents I ran into him. Tasha Blumberg will have a caterer on the other extension.
I'm afraid marrying him isn't the solution. Will you walk me back to Colgate?
Sure, if I can give myself up.
Look like a successful single woman?
Well,
what?
How do you know the wisdom of Tasha Blumberg?
Which one?
Always look nice when you take out the garbage. You never know who you're gonna meet. Put on your jacket, sweetheart.
again. Bye! Ms. Lambert, this is Julie Stein at Women's Sports Magazine. We've had your meeting with Olio. Our readers feel you haven't experienced that women's pain to stimulate our market. Okay? Thank you. Jamie, it took me off. There's a Live Men, Live Women mix at the Unitarian Church on Friday. It got a 4-star rating and went some trials. My cousin's a policeman at the anthropologist there, and she's in much worse shape than either of us. Wanna go?
Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play?
Is this the little girl I carry? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? Good morning, sweetheart. Congratulations on your new apartment.
What?
Your father and I came to celebrate your new apartment. What kind of a place is this? There isn't a doorman. Is this place safe for you?
What are you doing here?
You know your mother. I like life, life, life. I came to celebrate. I came over yesterday and you weren't home. So I got worried. I had the super give me the key. I thought something happened with the movers.
Nothing.
Isn't that nice? You can have breakfast with me and your father.
What are you doing?
I'm part of my morning dance class. Why don't you get up and do it with me? If you exercise, you have the energy to unpack and crate.
Mother, I've been here for 2 nights. I'll have it later.
Jamie, keep it away, wait. I like go-go, watch. I'll show you how to do it. You know, the girls at dancing school admire me so much. They say they wish their mothers had so much energy.
Their mothers probably wear clothes.
Why are you so modest?
Look, I'm your daughter. I should be seeing you in tie-dyed underwear.
You're making fun of me.
I'm not making fun of you. Daddy.
I said I'd pick up some coffee.
Do the girls at dancing think it's strange that you order a breakfast from a coffee shop every morning?
Sweetheart, when you get married, you make breakfast at your house and invite me. Anything you make is fine. You want to make sausages? I'll eat sausages. Do you know what sausages are made of? Jamie, please, don't lie there like a body. You had everything ahead of you. When you were in high school, other mothers would stop me on the street and say, you must be so proud of Jamie. She's such a brilliant child. If only my daughters were like Jamie.
What are the names of these mothers? I want names.
There's your father with the coffee.
Honey, is this place safe for you? You know, there's no doorman. Hey, why don't you put the lock on? I bought you in Brookline.
I left it there.
You left the lock in Brookline. That was a $50 lock.
I have it, Dad. I have it.
Hey, you want to share this donut with me, huh?
Simon, please. There's a proper way to do this. First, we have to toast Jamie's new apartment. I remember my first apartment in New York. Of course, I was much younger than you, and I was married to your father. To Jamie, congratulations, welcome home, and I hope next year you live in another apartment, and your father and I have to bring up 4 coffees.
You want me to have a roommate?
I want you to be happy. Talk to her, Simon, like a father and a daughter. But maybe she wants to tell you her problems.
I don't have any problems.
Yes.
Oh, so there's no
see something?
Sure.
Smell this!
It's nice.
Hey, I can't make them fast enough. And then those jerks sent me a million envelopes with no perfume. You know what that's gonna do to the Valentine's season? Oh, your father. Always with the headaches.
Oh, it's all right, Dad. I like the envelope. It smelled like the state of Maine.
Hey, so why don't you come down to the business? You know, look around, check it out, see how you like it. I can even take you skating afterwards.
Oh, I can't, Dad. I have to follow up some leads for some clients here, so some other time I'd like to.
Alright. Is that an outfit?
Yeah.
Simon, what's from a man's point of view? Is that what you would call an appetizing outfit?
Now, if you were a lawyer, like your brother Ben, then I could understand it, going out on your own. But I don't understand why a girl with your intelligence would want to freelance right when she could be taking over a business.
You know, Christ is thinking of going to law school when the children get a little older.
Who?
Your sister-in-law, Christ. Chris, mother, it's Chris.
I'll come down to your place next week, Dad, I promise.
All right, now take your time, whenever you're ready.
My two big doers. If not today, tomorrow. I just can't sit like you two.
I won't dance. Don't ask me.
Look at those thighs. I'm dying.
Hey, you know, what's his name called the other day?
Who?
The popover boy. Yeah, see, he called Ben because he and Ben went to summer camp together. But Ben didn't have your new number, so we told him to call us.
Ben told Party Sterling to call you?
Please, sweetheart, look nice. It's important, even when you throw out the garbage. I like this Party Sterling.
I don't even know him.
He comes from nice people.
His father is an arsonist.
Now believe me, you can have a good life with him. He seems like a very nice boy. He told me to give you a message to call him at the hospital. He works in the emergency room at Mount Sinai, huh?
I told you he was a nice boy.
Look, don't get too excited. He probably wants Harriet's number.
What does Harriet have to do with the popover boy?
He's her friend.
Why do you belittle yourself all the time? What kind of attitude is that? Why don't you walk into the room with your head up and your chest out and think, I am? Well, am I right, Simon?
What? What is it?
Please, don't
doesn't your mother look nice? That's a new attaché.
It looks very nice.
I'm an executive mother.
All right, hon. That's it. Time to go. And remember, rippled salt!
Hi. Janie, please. Hold the old lady's side. Hi.
Shower and the blood starts pumping out. Just think the traffic starts jumping to folks like me.
What's
on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. Yes, and five. It's all just and there's no giving. Just use your mind. Let's never keep me credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5. Or service.
Baby, what does he do?
He does all right.
Bill. I'll be there in a moment. My daughter is here with me. Bill, can she come to this meeting? I thought so. Thank you, Bill. It is a birthday thing. Harriet, why don't you come with me? You can be my date. Mother, do you remember when you used to take me to those group sales meetings in Barbados? And I would appear as your date in Mary Jane's, and we would sit by candlelit dinners by the ocean.
Of course I remember. You were a wonderful date. Interesting, attractive, and bright. Certainly more suitable than what was available.
Mother, you're so crazy! I just hope I'm going to be all right.
Oh, you'll be fine. Don't dwell on it, Harriet. Your generation is absolutely fascinated with itself. Think of something else. Think about science. Technology is going to change our world significantly. So, do you want to come?
Sure.
Oh, I dread going to these things.
Me too.
I'm not being too harsh.
No, Mother, you're not being too harsh.
Comb your hair away from your face, baby. You know I like it better that way.
Intermarriage,
Ivy League colleges, the New York Review of Books. So, how's Harriet?
Oh, she's fine.
She's not sweet like you.
Harriet is wonderful.
She's like those medical school girls. I mean, they're nice, but they bite your balls a lot. I mean, you think Israelis have no sense of humor? Believe me, women medical students are worse. Janie, you're one of the few real people I've met in a long time. Most of the girls I meet aren't funny.
Marty, I think I should tell you that I find the fact that you don't like women doctors extremely disturbing and discriminatory. I mean, I support the concept of Israel, and I would probably be a much happier, healthier person if I could go out to a desert full of course. But I am far too lazy and self-involved. I mean, I have very fat thighs, and I want very badly to be someone else without going through the effort of actually changing myself into someone else. I have very little courage, but I'm highly critical of those who don't.
That is.
And I want you to like me very much.
Do you like me?
Yes.
I know, that sounds tentative. I mean, most women fall in love the minute they hear Valari. Or maybe this will help. I got it for you while I was in Rome.
I was wondering why there was swizzle sticks in the wine.
Yeah, I got the connection in the restaurant business. So, should I take you home now, Monkey?
What?
You want to go home?
No, my interior decorator's there.
Yeah, when you go to my parents' house, you know, after Paramus, there's a UJA testimonial dinner for my father. It means a lot to him because he's been giving away so much free shrimp at the South Park, they almost revoked his license.
It's weird going to someone's parents' house. I mean, shouldn't we have mortgages and children?
Let's go, Monkey. You'll be all right.
I'll help you. What'll I do for you?
Just be sweet. I need attention. A great deal of attention.
Thank you.
My mother, she still lives on East 69th
Street. East 69th Street, so you're a rich kid.
No, no, upper middle class.
Harriet, only rich kids know what upper middle class is.
Well, I wasn't spoiled. Definitely not spoiled.
Was your mother a lawyer?
She's an executive.
Oh my God, is your mother Lillian Cornwall?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus! I interviewed with your mother once.
Ah, that woman has balls.
I mean, did you know what it took for a woman at her time to get as far as she did?
Yeah.
Oh. Or maybe I bet you do. You like me to spoil you a bit?
What?
You know, for a girl with such a good mind, you get too tense too easily. Why are you laughing?
Because you're just so amazing. I mean, first you tell me how amusing I am, and then you tell me that you want to spoil me, and now you tell me I have a great mind. So what's next? You're going to take me up to see your etchings? I'm sorry. This is just making me a little uncomfortable. Office romance and all that. I mean, you're my boss's boss.
Harriet, do you know that 40% of the people at McKinsey are having interoffice affairs?
How do you know that?
A friend of mine did the study. Look, I'm living with another woman right now, so nobody's going to know about me. Is that it,
Kathy. Do you live with Kathy?
How do you know Kathy?
Because she calls the office 3 times a day.
Well, you've been paying attention.
I'm a smart kid.
Well, you're a smart woman.
Paul, you know, I generally don't get involved with unavailable men.
Never been with a married man?
No.
Jesus, how old are you?
Are you all right?
God, were there any nuts in this pate? A doctor. Oh my God. My doctor told me to stay away from nuts.
Really? Dear.
I've got this stomach thing. I'll tell you, Beauty, when you get older, you really gotta start watching.
Yeah.
But, you'll take care of me, won't you, Beauty?
Where are you from originally?
You're excited. That's so cute. Don't worry, Harry. I'll be perfect for you. You'll try to change me, you'll realize you can't. Furthermore, I'm not worth it. So, you'll settle down and marry some nice investment banker and make your mother very, very happy.
I don't particularly think my mother wants me to get married. I don't want to get married.
You'll change your mind, Harriet. Career girls, when they get 30, they'll change their mind. Well, listen, whatever's happening here, we got to do it kind of quickly, because Kathy's expecting me home tomorrow. I think you're very attractive.
Come on.
supposed to bring walk into a new place with your right foot first in order to set you off on the right foot. Oh, here. Your housewarming gift. But you cannot open it until you get yourself in.
Harriet, you know I can't postpone gratification.
Janie, you have to make a home for yourself. Now, what are we going to do with these crates?
Harriet, oh. What are you doing? You're flying around the room.
It's Saturday.
Day of rest. Didn't they tell you that, the companion?
It's Paul Stewart's day at home with Kathy.
Oh.
Ooh. You want me to take this typewriter to keep
them? No. I'm working. Marty's father hired an actor to play a popover at the new Sterling Tavern opening in the Green Acres Mall.
Uh-huh.
So Marty got me the job writing the popover's opening remarks. Don't you mind not seeing Paul on the weekend?
No, it is okay. As I see it, Paul is just fine until I find the right relationship. It's similar to the case method. And he's great in bed.
You know, Marty, he claims he slept with over 100 visiting nurses while at home.
Really? Ooh!
No, I just told you that so you'd sit.
Is it something with Marty?
Oh, I don't know. He's opening his practice here next month, and he invited me over to his parents' house for Monica. You know, some days I'm walking down the street, and I think, if I don't step on any cracks, I'll marry Marty. Whatever happened to Janie Jill Glover? Oh, she did so well for herself. She married Marty, the doctor. They're giving away free popovers and pyramids.
I hate it when those women always complain that there are no men in New York. The men are either gay or they're married.
What does this have to do with my marrying Marty?
Because these kind of women are telling you, oh, he'll be a nice husband, he'll make a nice living, he'll even be a good father. But what these women like Cynthia Peterson don't know is, no matter how lonely you get, or how many birth announcements you receive, the trick is not to get frightened. There's nothing wrong with being alone.
You remember when we would sit around and listen to My Guy and iron our hair before going to the high school dance?
Oh God, I'm trying to block all of that.
Well, I remember writing at the dance, looking over all the prospects and thinking, when I'm 28, I'm going to get married to someone who is poor and fascinating. Well, until he's 30, and then he'll be very rich and wealthy after that. We'll have children who wear overalls and flannel shirts, who are kind and independent with curly blonde hair. And we'll still hold hands and have great sex when we travel to China together when we're 60.
I never thought about any of that. Maybe it's because I'm Lillian's daughter. But, you know, to compromise at this point would mean you weren't a person. To me, getting involved in a relationship right now, it's just anti-feminist. No. Anti-humanist. No. Well, just not impressive. I am not being too harsh.
No, just rhetorical.
What was that?
I don't know.
I know, hi.
Do you have my apartment?
You are Miss Gilmore?
Yeah.
Who are you? I'm Vladimir.
Okay.
I'm Russian. I'm Dimitri from Moscow. I'm Derek Paxman.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
Honey, do you like this stool? Hello, Harriet. Yeah, see, we thought we'd want to buy something to, lounge around in the home.
Don't force that. Hello, darling.
Well, Harriet, you look terrific. Are you seeing anyone?
Sort of.
Yeah, see, we met Vladimir here in the cab right down here. He just got in 6 months ago from Moscow, huh?
Oh, that's nice. Do you like it here?
Oh, hello. See, he doesn't speak very much English at all.
That doesn't matter. If you like people, you speak every language. I can get along in any country. If you smile, you dance, anyone will understand.
My mother identifies with Zorba the Greek.
Zorba, yes, thank you.
Well, Harriet, do you
some coffee. Coffee!
Coffee, regular, please.
All right.
Come! Harriet, join us! Harriet's with Colgate Palmolive.
He's a nice boy, isn't he, huh? He seems like a very nice boy. He's intelligent, too. I figured if things don't work out between you and Monty, we can bring him into the business, you know.
You're kidding. The man's here 6 weeks and he gets a wife, a business, and a dancing mother-in-law?
What's wrong with giving the guy a break?
Dad!
All right. Vladimir! We're going to take the cab up to Rockefeller Center now, okay?
Every Saturday, I take Mr. Blumberg skating.
Yeah, and my partner keeps me in shape, I'll tell you.
So, Harriet, you look terrific. Who do you think that you're seeing?
She's seeing someone who's married.
Oh, let's go, dear.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I swear, one of these days, I'm going to write a book. My mother herself. I'm sorry, Hattie. That's the only thing I can do to get her out of here.
Hey, did Tasha go on safari?
No, she went hunting at Kmart. God, Hattie, can you believe that they brought over our Russian taxi cab driver for me to marry?
Oh, maybe I will move back to Brooklyn tomorrow.
You can't leave me here with Lillian and Paul Stewart. Do you know I brought Lillian a birthday present with my last lira in Italy, and she finally opened it. She couldn't wait to get back on the intercom to harass Pauline. Let's just relax, girl. It is the day of rest. Oh, you can open up your present now.
Oh.
Harriet, what kind of diet are you on?
Well, according to the Oxford Companion, this is what you bring someone when they move into a new home. Bread, the steak they look like. Sugar, something sweet in your life. And salt, a little spice. And a candle to light the way. You know what I remember more than those mixes, Jamie?
What?
Well, remember when you and I would have dinner because Lil was at a meeting and Tasha only had brewers in the refrigerator? Well, I always thought I do have a family. Jamie's my family. You know, I just assumed it was some sort of pact.
It is a pact. Harriet, thank you for my gift to my family. Cheers.
Lashane.
Lakine.
Clark Carroll from Personnel Department 73. A friend in our office recognized your name from a parking place at the Green Acres Mall. I heard your pieces. I'm going to pass them on to Tazi, Vlad, Spiegel Bear. That was a nice song.
Goodbye. Jamie, it's Cynthia. Thank God you have your machine on. I'm home, I'm thrilled, my trainer is on retreat, I've been rejected by every man on the upper west side, and I'm about to get drunk. Jamie, do you know what's a dry cleaner?
How sweet it is to be loved.
Defense.
sense, sweetheart.
Why do you think by you was so simple?
Everything by you was harder than it has to be. I mean, hey, you think my sister-in-law knew what she was doing when she married my brother? That didn't come out right, did you?
That's okay.
Like, you know what I mean. My sister-in-law had even less direction than you do, and she's a bright girl, too. But she met my brother, and now she's a wonderful mother. And believe me, when Shlomo is a little older, she'll go back to working something nice. She'll teach, or she'll work with the elderly. She won't change the world, but she'll have a nice life. Monkey, I don't want to be alone. But I think it's going to be all right with us. I love you. No, I put a deposit down on an apartment for us in Brooklyn today.
What?
Well, I figured if I waited for you to wait and make up your mind, you'd never take anything. I need a place to live before I open my practice. Hey, you know, you don't have to do your half of the deposit now. I can wait a month. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure. Fine.
You know what? I decided that we should live in Flatbush or Brighton Beach where people have real values. I mean, my father never sees those people anymore. Alton Cock is in Brooklyn, the old man with the accents who sits in a high-vis highway delicatessen. I miss them. And you know, my father never goes to Miami anymore. I mean, he goes to Palm Springs or Martinique with his friends from the Westchester Country Club. My father thought my brother was crazy when he named his son Shlomo. He kept asking him, so what's his real name? My father will think I'm crazy when I tell him we're moving to Brooklyn.
Marty,
what is it, Monkey? Are you mad at me?
No, I like the Alton Cock's in Brooklyn too. Boy, stop from him, books to write another novel, Young Cock's.
I know. Janie, what don't you know? You're 28 years old. But all I'm saying is that either you want to be with me, you don't have to, you should just want to. And if you don't want to, then we should just forget it.
I want to.
So what's the problem?
No problem.
Uh-oh, hey, what time is it? You know, I promised my father we'd watch this new commercial on television.
I know that man.
This is Captain Milton Sterling. I'm here at the beautiful Green Acres Mall with the popover boy, my grandson, Shlomo. What are we giving away today, Shlomo?
We're giving away the shrimp, and we're giving away the lobster tails, and we're giving away the coleslaw.
How do you like that shrimp, Shlomo?
It's good, Grandpa.
Sterling Tavern is now located in Green Acres, Syosset, Paramus, Albany, Plattsburgh, Marine Park, Midwood, Madison, Bethesda, and the Bergen Mall.
What are you laughing at? God, this man's a marketing genius. He's giving away shrimp. He's giving away lobster. The only two things he can give away and still make a profit.
Grandpa. Where are you going?
Wait.
Oh, you could spend the night.
Kathy.
Do you love Kathy?
Well, she's devoted to me.
Does Kathy really exist?
Of course Kathy exists.
Oh, because I thought she was just someone you hired for your answering service three times a day.
Didn't I tell you the deal from spring?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I know sometimes I can be kind of a jackass, but you're sweet, Harriet. I mean, you're a sweet woman. A lot of people never give up in their entire life. Do you think your mothers have good sex?
My mother watches the Robert Bell reruns every night at 11 o'clock. I don't think people think about sex as much as you do, Paul.
Well, then tell me what you like.
Okay. I was by your office the other day with my perk charts. And I overheard you call your secretary Beauty. I even heard you call everyone that called you on the telephone Beauty. You even called the 90-year-old messenger boy from Ogilvy and Mather Beauty.
I know what this is. This is the whole, I'm afraid of turning 30 alone and I'm thinking about starting a family.
Paul, I don't think wanting two nights a week or sleepover day is quite a family.
Maybe I'm older than you. I've been through this with a lot of different women. I mean, the other one, a man who isn't threatened by your success, but is deeply interested in it. And he should be thought of as intelligent by your friends, but whenever you need him, you should drop whatever it is he's doing and be supportive.
I'm not asking for any of that. Why are you so bitter?
Don't be naive, Harriet. Everything is a negotiation. I mean, when I graduated from Yale, I thought I'd find a nice wife who would cook me dinner every night.
we'd have a few kids and settle down, and I'd support a family. A few years up the road, we'd get a nice house in Madison, Connecticut. But the woman I married didn't know how to cook. And she wasn't lucky like you. I mean, girls didn't assume they'd have careers back then. And the girls I see now, the ones like you, the MBAs from Harvard, they all want me to be the wife. They want me to be the support system, and I can't do that. I just wasn't told that's the way it was supposed to be.
Paul, I never knew which way it was supposed to be.
What do you mean?
I don't expect anything from you.
You and I are a lot alike, Harriet. We don't want to be alone, but we don't want to move forward. We serve this perfect function blocking each other's lives.
I just like you, Paul.
Boy, I'm hungry. Hey, what do you got to eat around here, Monkey?
We could order up a sandwich. We have the number of every coffee shop on the Upper East and West Side. The Four Brothers on the Acropolis, the Four Brothers on the Parthenon, the Four Brothers on the...
You know what? I think I'll just go to the supermarket and I'll get some chicken and some lettuce and stuff.
No. We can order up a salad.
Monkey, you don't know how to cook your chicken?
Oh, no, I do. I can make Teflon chicken.
Shouldn't put yourself down like that.
Marty, I love you. We can take a place in Brooklyn. I just want to be with you. Okay.
Hello?
Harry, how are you cooking chicken? Marty's coming back here in 5 minutes with a chicken!
The deal was 14 or something.
Harry, hurry! I can't tell him. I don't know how. He took an apartment for us in Brooklyn today. I can't tell him we have to order up a chicken.
Why Brooklyn?
I don't know. He likes Hobby's and Hobby's Highway Delicatessen.
Excuse me.
He likes the Alta Tacos. Just a second, Marty.
Judy, do you have any dye gel?
In the cabinet. But Jamie, what are altered tacos? Hello?
Hello, hi. I am a neighborhood, so I dropped by. Want to go see the sorrow and the pity?
Harriet, Flavier's here. He wants to see the sorrow and the pity. When can I see you?
I don't know. I don't have my book here.
Oh, what's wrong with this mouthwash?
It's the Colgate product.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hello, Flavier.
Hello.
Jane, I thought I brought you over a coffee table, you know, for your own.
I better go.
Me too, the rock tiles.
Monkey, I'm home with the chicken.
Marty, this is my father, Simon Blumberg. This is Vladimir.
Nice to meet you, my boy. Miss Blumberg, we're so sorry she missed you.
Hello, hi.
Yeah, this is Vladimir. He's a friend of mine. Jamie doesn't even know him. He's a filmmaker from Moscow, huh? All right, well, time to go. Let's go, Vladimir.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, yeah, that's right.
I think we have a good thing going. Think about it.
So, who's the filmmaker?
Oh, he's just a friend of my father's.
Jamie!
Well, I'm hungry here.
Sure, Jamie!
I'll get one on the oven.
Oh, I'll get the stapler.
Jamie, when did you see the apartment?
I haven't seen it yet. You told me about it tonight after I spoke horse Spanish on baby Shlomo.
Jamie, people named Homo and Slimy. Yeah, I think our move back to New York has been successful. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think I'm involved with the Sadist Vice President, and you've been involved with the Stettle.
Stettle.
Okay.
Be right there, Marty. How do you cook a chicken?
You just put it in the boiler.
Who told you this? Okay, bye.
Hey, Judy. On Thursday night, the laundry's open until midnight.
What? The oven's ready.
Thank you.
such feelings coming over me.
My mother identifies Jean Harris.
I think Jean's mistake was stopping with Dr. Turner. On her way to Scarsdale, she should have just taken care of all. Dr. Atkins, Dr. Pritikin, the not Beverly Hills assistant. Good.
I hear you, Mrs. Rosen, I hear you. No, I was up all night with her. She thinks the dialysis machine is connected to my telephone. Do you have a private one I can use?
In the kitchen. He's sweet.
Very sweet. Sometimes I look at Marty and think, he's such a nice young man, I must be a nice young girl.
You are.
Well, I never meant to become one. The other day when we were driving up from yet another Sterling Tavern opening on the island, I had my head in his lap, he was stroking my hair, and he called me monkey. And I thought, Jamie Jill Blomberg, you've finally been accepted, not even on the way to work. So he calls you a monkey. You prefer what? Angel, sweetheart,
beauty.
And I thought, fine, it's settled. Thank God. And I bet I can't convince him that Shlomo is not a name for an American child. As we're traveling along the LIE, I was wondering whether or not we'd make the Sunday time wedding announcements. Daughter of pioneer in interpretive dance, marries Papa Burboy. And it was just as we're approaching Syosset that I thought, God, I can't breathe in this car. And I promised myself that in a month from now, I would not be traveling home from the island in this car with Marty. But as soon as I thought this, and honestly, I was pushed open.
Is that kid's name really Shlomo?
Yes. Actually, the UGA is really pissed at my father for making Shlomo eat shrimp on television.
Yeah! That was a great commercial.
More for you, Marty? How are you feeling?
I don't know. Now I've got this weird sensation in my foot. I mean,
no.
I'm wondering if this is all some weird neurological thing.
Well, maybe.
No, it doesn't seem to be.
Oh, and what's your specialty?
Kitty.
Oh, that was a great commercial, though. Oh, well.
Are you in marketing?
Yeah, but that's a little too boring to talk about.
I don't think it's boring. Gherkins!
So, anybody seen anything good recently?
Oh God, you know, I haven't been to a film in ages. When I get any free time, I try to read.
Did you read that article in the Times about artificial insemination? I can imagine myself driving across country at age 36 to inseminate myself with an attorney based on...
What's the matter, baby? You got your period?
We'll see you later.
No, 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 no.